Greetings, Kiss Nation. It's Evergreen Retreat album, How to Rock Fans and Influence People in Australian Tribute to Kiss. This came out in 1997, and sorry it took me a while to get to reviewing albums again. It's been a while, and if you want to know why it took me so long to get back to reviewing albums, I made a channel update kind of explaining why it took me a while to get back in action. But anyways, this is a really solid tribute album. And before I talk about the album, let's talk about the cover. Because it took me a while to like talk about the tribute album cover. This cover has Gene's Axe Bass, Ace's Les Paul, one of like Paul's signature broken mirror glass guitar, and Peter Criss's drumstick with what we assume to believe is Peter's hand holding the drumstick. And yeah, I kind of like this album cover, and the song choices are pretty good. They chose songs from the 80s, the 90s, and the 70s. And what I think about them? Well, let's get this review started.
During the late 70s, a band like no other rocked Australia. That band's name is Kiss, and this is their army.
Black weather. Shock me, we can was talking to somebody backstage before, and they would tell me there's a lot of you people there that like to drink vodka and orange juice. Yeah. I'll tell you something. When you're down in the dumps and you need something to bring you up, there's only one thing that's gonna do it the way you want it. What's that?
Thoughts on how to rock fans and influence people in Australian Tribute to Kiss. Like I said, it's an awesome tribute album. It's got some solid songs, some solid song choices. And for my thoughts on the songs, well, here they are. First, we have an introduction by J. Pollen B. Drought, who just gives his introduction to the album and about Kiss in some, like, an Australian fashion, which isn't much, but it's kind of cool anyway. Then the official opening track to the album is Unholy by Hyper Ion. I think that's how you pronounce the name. I think I'm going to botch it, but anyways. Their version of Unholy, it's kind of cool. Like, it's a mixture of, like, how Unholy is, then after the guitar solo, you get like this little soft drum solo type of deal. Then we get into the "I lay you down to sleep, your soul to keep" bit, which that's kind of cool. You get like this neat little drum bit, then that's kind of cool. I like that. Then we get "Almost Human" by Street Trash Circus, which, as I've said, in the 90s, Kiss Tribute albums on Almost Human has gotten like a really bad track record. But for this one, it's half and half. We get like a good vocalist for Almost Human, but the backing vocals are not there. So it's almost there, basically. But it took until like later Kiss Tribute albums on, like, later years to finally kind of nail Almost Human. I will say, like, the perfect rendition of Almost Human is on Kiss My Chilean Ass, like, for a Kiss Tribute album. But that wasn't until 2022, so. But as for a 90s Kiss Tribute album, this isn't terrible. Like, you can at least put up, you can at least have, like, a solid vocalist for the song. That's pretty good. But "Shock Me" by Loudhailer. This is really cool. You get like a punk version of "Shock Me." That's fucking kick ass. I love this. This is awesome. And I love it when bands do like a punk version of Kiss song. This is awesome. I like this. Let me get "Shandy" by Matt Bradshaw, who starts off by playing the piano, sings the song, then after a little bit you hear like the typical Shandy drum intro, then it gets right into the song. And that's pretty cool. I like that way. I like that. Then we get "Cadillac Dreams" by Root Beer. Now, "Cadillac Dreams" has never made on another Tree album except for this. And it's kind of interesting because, like, there's been a lot of Hot in the Shade songs like a lot of Hot Machete deep cuts that have made it to number two. I reviewed Buffalo Rock City 2, Who Heck Do You Love Me to Hate You, which that's never been on number two that I've noticed since. Or it's never been true before until that one. And Cadillac Dream has never been on a tribute album before since this one, apparently. So, yeah, this is a good rendition of Cadillac Dreams. There's like a robot-like voice saying, "I gotta have it," at one point in the song, which is, that's pretty funny. I like that. So this is a good version of Cadillac Dreams. I like that. I wish more Hot Machete deep cuts would come out on tribute albums. This is pretty cool. Then we got Beth by Brad Drought. I wish I pronounced that name. This is not a bad version of Beth. We get like a mix of an orchestra with acoustic guitar. That's pretty cool. I like that. Then we got Pain doing Is That You, which this is a heavy metal like type version of Is That You, which that fucking rules. I like that. It's more heavy than what you get on a mask, I'll tell you that for sure. That's pretty funny. No, that's awesome. I like that. That fucking rules. Then we got like a Kiss medley by Good Fellas. And the medley consumes of All American Man, then it jams into 100,000 Years, then it goes into I Still Your Love. That's how the medley ends. And it's pretty good. I like that. The singer does a good job of sustaining the songs. Even though it's a medley, it's pretty good. I like that. Then we got Love Gun by Big Tuna. Interesting name. But this is another one of those mellow versions of a Kiss song. Which is kind of interesting. Like since Kiss My Ass and even past Kiss My Ass, like in the later years, three albums, there's always, in some albums, there's always like a mellow type of like mellow version of a Kiss song. And it works, surprisingly, it works. And I like hearing Love Gun in a mellow way. It's pretty cool. That was like a mellow version of Detroit City on another Tree album, which that was pretty cool. I like that. And speaking of Detroit City, Empire is doing Detroit City, and it's really damn good. It's probably like one of the heaviest versions of Detroit City that I've heard on a Tree album, and it's fucking kick ass. This really kicks so much ass. I love it. The vocalist does a really damn good job at getting the high notes that Paul used to get. That's really cool. Then we got Cold Gin by Bad Karma. This one's really interesting because it starts off with the Alive intro that we all know and love from Kiss Alive. And obviously they kind of alter it because towards the end it's a bit more echoed. So the band could, you know, do their thing. But, yeah, this is really cool. Like, I like Bad Karma's version of Cold Gin. This is, like, a really awesome song to close it out with. Then after they do the closing, you hear, like, the audience applauding them. So that's pretty cool. So there you have it. How to Rock Fans and Influence People in a Street on Tribute to Kiss is an awesome tribute album. I did not find a bad song in there. I mean, there was like a couple things wrong with Almost Human, but to it, all in all, this wasn't a bad version of Almost Human. This is not a bad version of Almost Human. So this is kind of like, we have a listenable version of Almost Human from a nice tribute album. So, you know, things are looking up. So yeah, first album, I would give it a 10 out of 10. This is a solid Kiss tribute album from the 90s and a solid Kiss tribute album in general. I mean, this has got like a bunch of kick-ass songs, like a great song selection, a lot of awesome, like there's like a great deep cut in there, like with Cadillac Dreams. Like I would not expect your Cadillac Dreams on a tribute album, and they did it really damn good. So that's awesome. And this album is just so fun to listen to. Like I enjoy Bad Karma's Cold Gin. Like I said, I enjoy Cali Dreams. I love the punk version of Shock Me. This is just so fucking fun to listen to. It's just, I love it. So yeah, 10 out of 10. So that's my review of How to Rock Bands and Influence People on Australian Jubilee Kiss. Hope you liked it. Next time we meet, I'll be reviewing Dress to Frill. Later.
Darkness, there's so much I wanna do.